So my name is Stephanie. I am a rising 3L at Harvard Law School. I am mainly interested in the transactional space, so I got good exposure in FRE, FSG, and CNS. And I also did other types of assignments. I did IP, I did some pro bono, and also took on a litigation assignment. So I think it was a very fruitful summer so far.
I'm Rachel Leary. I'm a rising 3L at UVA. It was a great experience, and I came in thinking I was interested in litigation, but also being interested in CNS, and I think the way that they structured the summer program really allowed me to explore, but then increasingly hone in on the litigation side when I realized that's what I really wanted to do. So at this point, I'm working on a mix of products, TIS, and antitrust work, and just have gotten great exposure.
I think the highlight to me was the mock negotiation workshop we had last month. That was super interesting. We did it in one of the conference centers here in the New York office, and we had this exercise where we simulated a semi-failed negotiation. I definitely felt the emotional impact of that exercise, and I thought it was very good and safe environment to do it with your summer class and with your friends to experience what is important in a negotiation setting that is very intense.
One of my first assignments really sticks out to me, and I worked on this really kind of factually interesting 1983 pro bono case, and just was given a lot of responsibility, really was brought in as part of the team, included on, client phone calls, settlement negotiations, co-defendant counsel conversations, and just really felt like I got to kind of hit the ground running.
I really appreciate the assignment system here because I mentioned that I did have exposure to a variety of assignments throughout the summer, and I really appreciate how the recruiters would make sure that your wishes are fulfilled every week.
I've had a really great experience this summer with Dechert's LGBTQ plus affinity group. They had a pride event that I think really spoke to their kind of unique commitment to diversity, not just, celebrating pride and, let's have brunch and have pink drinks and have fun, which is important too, but, bringing in the, Matthew Shepard's parents and the Shepard Foundation was just a really moving experience to really trace back, the importance of the history of pride. And I think that really speaks to a unique perspective that the group has on diversity here.